Sorry, let us give for some time. People join. Okay, so let me move on to that next slide. So the question so I want to ask is, if our the material knowledge temporary stored in the brain, we all know that we are intelligent, higher than our intelligence is higher than the mind. If so, why intelligence comes from mode of passion and the mind comes from mode of goodness? Let me repeat again. So we always, the intelligence, it controls our mind. Whatever activity we want to do, the intelligence is try to control. But the intelligence coming out of mode of passion and the mind is coming out of goodness. Generally goodness, sattvic, sattva is supposed to be higher than the passion. But if you see the other way around, our intelligence is in the mode of passion and the mind is in the mode of goodness. So this is a food for thought. We can discuss probably next week. I will answer you these questions. Why it's so. So to conclude this, our can we learn all these slokas? As I mentioned, the living entity forgets as soon as he quits his body. Atha pravista sastha jnanam. We will complete all the knowledges. But as soon as we hear this, vedair giyate, so this will be reminded to us. So moving on to the today's topic, the objective of this session. We don't want to beat around the bush. To the point, I will just tell you the essence of the Vedas. As I mentioned, you can't read all the Vedas. I'm going to give a gist of Vedas, which means that Bhagavad Gita is the essence of all the Vedas. Whatever you want to know, it is all specified in the Vedas, the essence of Vedas in the Bhagavad Gita. So there are, when you write Mangalacharan prayers or when you select some slokas, any author would do three things. One is that you want to convey the objective. When you write the first paragraph or first sloka or first page or first chapter, the author would convey saying that, what is it I want to achieve in this program? So here I'm telling you can't read the entire Vedas, the essence of Vedas given in Bhagavad Gita. Number two, you invoke the prayers for the auspiciousness to complete it. The third thing is benediction for all the people who are hearing this Veda. So what I'm going to get? What is the benefit of by today attending this satsanga today? So that's the three thing is mentioned in this simple sloka. Sri Bhagavanu Vacha Urdva Moolam Madashakam Ashvatam Prahur Avyayam Chandam Sri Yashya Parnani Yashtam Vedasa Vedavet. This is the sloka to be remembered for our session. Here the Lord said, the Vedas like a reverse banyan tree, upside down banyan tree. The roots are upward, the branches are down, the leaves are here. So this is the Vedas he is explaining about it. Some of you may not be able to see this diagram which I am showing it in the mobile or in the laptop, but let me explain. You can see in this diagram, there is a tree you can see in the bottom. In the middle, you can see the desire. There is a river written. Then beyond that, there is a tree where Radha Krishna, Supreme Lord, is there. Now in the bottom, if you see closely, some of you may be able to find out, there are animals. Can you spot a tiger? Can you spot a cow? You can spot a snake. And you can spot a deer. Anybody else can't spot any other animals? So these animals are the level one. The next level, you can spot a people, a human being, And also you can spot a Gandharva who is singing, or he is playing a mridanga. Also you can see demigods like Surya. Then also you can see Ganeshji is there. Indra is there in the elephant, who is sitting on the elephant. You can see that. And the third level, you can see there is a Brahma who is sitting on the kind of lotus arrangement. You can see from him the root starts. He is the prime. The tree root starts from Brahma, because we are all created from Brahma. The Brahma, through the down, there are so many branches. There are demigods, then we have human being, then we have animal. Now, interestingly, you can also notice there are fruits in this tree. There are some fruits which is red color. That fruits are in green color. These fruits are called Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. So I will explain you all these things. It may be a little confusing, because these Vedas are generally a little high philosophy. So what happens is, in this
What is the source? I'm sorry. This is Pushpendra. What is the source of this picture?
This is the same sloka which I'm talking about. So this is Bhagavad Gita 15.1. You can go and read the purport of the source I've given always in the presentation at the end. Okay. The references what are given are taken from that, and you will see that throughout the presentation where is this reference. And this is detailed explained. I've taken that purport. I'm putting it in the pictorial. It's available, or I would have created it. Then I'm explaining this concept. So this entire thing is there in this Bhagavad Gita 15.1. Please feel free to refer.
The
leaf is called Vedic hymns. So what is happening? The soul is jumping from one branches to another branch, the living entity, human being. The leaves are supposed to be the Vedic hymns through which we can cut through this root. The branches are nothing but various planets. So you can chant some Surya mantra. You can go to Surya Loka. The Vedas have that. We have Chandra mantra. You want to go to moon, you can't go by the, unfortunately, I'm sorry to say this, you can't go by racket. You have to go by chanting particular worship or chanting particular mantra to moon, godhead, Chandra. Then you can go to this planet. So our life in living entity, using this option available in the Vedas, the living entity thinks, okay, let me happy going to heaven. Let me go to Indra Loka. Let me go to that Loka. Can we go to this Loka? Or let me in the material go to different places, including America and other places. We keep jumping branches to branches, right? The leaf, which is the Vedic hymns, which can help us to cut through these branches and go the roots from Brahma Loka to cross that river, which is desire, and go to the other side of the river. Now, the root is called material existence. This we bonded in this roots, which is called material existence. The subroot, which is aversion as well as attraction to different things, which is dharma, nothing but dharma, artha, kama, moksha. The fruits are the benefits what we are going to derive in Vedas. The Vedas talk about these four things, and that is the fruit we are going to eat. Sometimes we eat green mangoes, sometimes orange. There are different kind of fruits which are trying to do it, right? Now, in this diagram, if we want to, so then also I would quickly give you a food for thought. This you can go and research. Or I can give you the sloka. This Bhagavad Gita 13.6, again I'm repeating. This would talk about how this material world is made of. There are 24 elements this material world is made of. This Pancha Bhutas, there are Pancha Jnana Indriyas, Karma Indriyas, and the object senses, Indriya Gochara, and Ahankara, Buddhi, mind, and three modes of material nature. This put together 24 elements. I'm not dwelling into this because we don't have time, but this is the reference sloka. It will detail explain about these elements if you want to reference, or next week I can answer specific question to this. So the leaf, end of the leaf, that's are the senses. The twig is considered as the sense objects. Sense object is your smelling, feeling, touching, all those stuff. Through the senses, the 10 senses which I talked about, one is Karmendriya and five Jnanendriya and Karmendriya, through 10 senses, we try to acquire this sense object, we try to enjoy. That is the twig as well as the tip of the branch is called senses. So this is what the Vedas talks about, our senses, how we are entangled, how we are going to different branches, to different worlds. And from the Brahma, the root starts. This is a, in the river, you can see the tree image is upside down. But our job is to cut down this network, and we need to reach beyond this river, the other side of it. Now, one might ask, how do we do that? So the Vedas talks about the title of this touchstone I was talking about, becoming sanata from anata. So what does that mean? We get married, we have parents. You can say, how can you say I am anata? It is like, you know, when you go on the train, you get five people together, you meet them, you tag, you make a friends, you chat with them. After that, we go to our different places. Or the twigs comes together in the river, after some time it will be separated. Similarly, we might have different parents for this lifetime, different lifetime, but we should know there is an ultimate parent, a father who is there. So unless we know our identity as well as the relation with the Lord, we are called anathas, because we don't have this supreme father. We might have temporarily material bodily concept fathers and parents, which are definitely required. Through Krishna's mercy only we get them and we come into this material world. However, we should also know the origination of the father. The Brahma is called Pitamaha, and Param Pitamaha is called Krishna. So to understand, make you understand, there is a beggar whose father was multimillionaire. He had a big business. This kid was spoiled kid. He would not do anything. He would go and his friends spend money, all illicit activities. He's not a good person. He doesn't want to learn anything. Lazy, fighting with people. His father fed up. He was getting a bad name to everyone. So his father said, you get out of this house. I don't want you here. So you want to teach a lesson to him. And this guy went out. He didn't know, because he was pampered. He doesn't know any skill set. He didn't learn anything. He can do a little bit singing. So he started singing in the street, begging. And this time went by. It has been 15 years. He forgot completely who he was. Suddenly his father getting old, business is not able to manage. Only son, millionaire, what he to do? He said, okay, where is my son? Can you go and find out? He told his managers. The managers were going around searching for this person. They finally found he was begging. He didn't have slippers. He was his leg was wounded. He's bleeding. He doesn't have any jackets. As soon as the manager found out him, he said, hey, no, you are such and such a person, son. He said, yeah, your father wanted to come back. Then he realized his original identity. Then immediately he checked into the 5-star hotel nearby. He immediately ordered a big, nice car. Then he had a nice food. Then people nearby, they just called him, hey, 1 minute before you are begging in front of my shop. Do you know that? And you are asking for some food. And now you're just now going in the Rolls Royce and, you know, what kind of dress you are wearing now. He said, I didn't know my identity. Now I know my identity. So the Vedas similarly talk about, there are three things. Any Vedas, any scripture you want to know, somebody, any class you're going, you should ask these three things. Vedas talks about only three things. Samanda, Avideya, Priyojana. This is, again, this shloka is taken from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Veda Shastra kahe sambandha videya priyojana Krishna prapya sambandha bhakti praptyera sadhana. So here, how this person immediately identified who is my father. Similarly, we from the Vedas learn our sambandha, who is my father. Then we become from anatta, we just add yes to our life, we will become sanatana, which is eternal. Then we will, the later is, first is Sambandha, then later is Avideya. How do I, what is the process to achieve him? There are various means. Any religion who comes, everything has to come from Vedas. There is nothing exists beyond Vedas. Everything has come from Vedas. Even Quran, Bhagavad Gita, let it be a Bible, any Granthas which has come, it has all come from Vedas. There is no other source. Any religion, those who follow this relationship to the God, they are all called Sanatana Dharma. It is not Hindu, for your kind information. Sanatana Dharma is not any religious sect. It is not for any particular purpose. It is for everyone, every humankind who was born in this world. every religion, some portion of it, they take Vedas, they start a religion, something it comes, but it is the original Sanatana Dharma is what Vedas talking about. We are not talking about any sectarian here. Okay. Now, similarly, why I showed in the right-hand side the proof for saying that, how do I know who is my Paramapita? So you can see that in the Vedas and Upanishad especially, explains detailedly how this creation happens. You can see there are three personalities, one called Karanadakshaya Vishnu, second one is Garbhadakshaya Vishnu, third one is Shirodakshaya Vishnu. Karana means casual ocean, Sai means one who lies on the ocean. All he is also called Mahavishnu. He from his pores is breathing out. You can see the first picture right topmost corner. A lot of globe is coming out of his body. Then you take one globe, dissect it, you see inside there is a Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Garbha means womb. From the womb, Garbha ocean, there is a navel. From navel is what Brahma comes. So there are innumerable universe, there are innumerable Brahma. There is not only one Brahma. Every Brahmanda has one Brahma. Some Brahma has 10 head, somebody has 1 million head, somebody has 400 head. So our 400 Brahma is what this particular planet is in charge. But there are so many Brahmas who has thousand millions of heads. Don't ask me how do they look like, but it is mentioned in the scripture. The Brahma, then he creates this world, right? Karanadakshaya Vishnu, who is as a Paramatma, enters as a every living entity into our atom of every living entity. This is the three personality. Why I'm telling is, this is our Sambandha. To know that this is how the universe is created. So he is my father. So the Veda talks about Veda is our mother. Veda is compared to our mother. If you want to know your father, as soon as you're born, you say, see daddy, can you call daddy? Or your sister or brother will call daddy. Then the kid also start automatically calling father. The kid will not say, no, let me experiment. Who is my father? I don't know who is my father. You can't find out. You have to ask your mother. So Veda is our mother. Mother says, he is the three personality who created you. Vishnu is your father. So Sanatana Dharma does not reflect any sectarian process. It is the Veda gives the Sambandha, Avideya, Prayojana. So this is the benefit of knowing this Vedas today's session. So I've talked about the tree, how we are, the Vedas are talking about Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. One should go beyond. The objective of this Vedas are three things, Sambandha, Avideya, Prayojana, which explains the benefit of through this various knowledge branches in the Vedas. That's how we become that. Okay, now moving on to what is that all about? What is this Veda contains? It's called a desire tree. The entire encyclopedia of the knowledge, you take anything in the material or spiritual, it could be mathematics, it could be physics, it could be a chemistry, or it could be any computer. You take any knowledge, it originally comes from Vedas. There is nothing exists outside the Vedas. There is no knowledge not there in the Vedas. It is very difficult to understand in this modern age that how can you say that? I thought Veda is something some sectarian people, some religious people use it. No, any program you do or any knowledge, civil engineering or any innovation you are doing it, everything is there in the Vedas. There is nothing outside available in the Vedas. So I've given some of the examples like cosmology, politics, civil engineering, art and culture, ecology, medicine, which is Ayurveda here. I'm not talking about the modern medicine. This is medicine means when I refer it's Ayurveda here. When I say algebra, it is Vedic mathematics. Yes, these are available. Nowadays, few of things we have access to it. Some of them we don't have access to it. Now, the famous scientists, let it be Albert Einstein or Warner Kahl, the recent innovation of quantum theory, they all say this Vedas making sense to us. This Upanishad is telling already this. So we need to connect the spirituality to the science. You can do various R&Ds. It is not, I'm telling that material knowledge is not useful. But when you are a doctor, then you know that there is a Paramatma who is controlling it. The result will be dependent on that. You might try all your best to do operation, but they'll always say it is God's hand, trust is God's hand, right? They all know there is a soul where time has come, he has to go. Similarly, the scientists, they want to find out quantum theory, how it works. He should know there is a person who has created this planet. There is a karma theory. There is a reincarnation. You can't just say a human has come from a monkey. right? So this right hand side, the pratyaksha pramana, anumana pramana, sabda pramana, this is food for your thought. Of course, I'm going to cover this in the next channel. There are three ways of acquiring and the knowledge. One is directly you perceive it. Another one is you analyze it. Another one is this shabda pramana. So the Vedas comes in this sabda pramana. So tomorrow or next session, we are going to find out which of the three are there. What are the three? Which is the best? Why Vedas we need to learn through sabda pramana? So that is the food for thought. With that, I'm just coming to today's topic. I might take another 15 minutes if it's okay with you. If I might slightly move out the time because of the lot of other things, but I want to present this, then probably I can open for more questions. As I mentioned, there are three levels and three levels. Can all of you please go on mute? Thank you so much. So I said, we're going to see only Shruti part of it, little bit of introduction today. And the complete Shruti, I will do it next week. Smriti will be done on the third week. The Naya part of it, in the white hand side, I've given one table which you may not be read. That's fine. But these are the agenda which I'm going to cover. So let me quickly come to the Shruti part of it. This is the what part of knowledge. What is the knowledge that is there in the Shruti? Smriti is how part of the knowledge. How do I understand this? It will supplement. Shruti will supplement the Shruti saying that how do I understand this Rig? It's very difficult to understand. So the Shruti, Smriti will help you, the Pranas, Idigasas will help you, the story form, how to understand this. Because Vedas are Apurushaya, means it is not written by any human being. One might ask how the Vedas first of all came into place, who has spoken when. The Shruti means, as I showed you in the previous diagram, that is Garbhodaka Shai Vishnu. From his Garbhodaka Shai Vishnu, let me go back if you don't remember. So there's a Brahma coming out of the novel. So as soon as he came, he was bewildered. He didn't know. Everything is dark. He's going to the stem. The stem has 18 planetary system. He's going and searching everything. Nobody's to be found. Heavy wind, very dark. He don't know. Then he heard a sound called tapa. Then he started meditating. Then Krishna came, Vishnu came and shook hands with Brahma. Then he revealed this, how to create this. Veda is meant for creating the universe. So the Veda's knowledge imparted in the heart of the Brahma automatically. I told you about these 24 elements, which I said you can do a Homer, food for thought. These 24 elements Brahma uses. He is like an architect. The ingredients are already there. He constructs a building. So the Brahma takes these 24 material elements and the knowledge is given how to create this. Right, so that is the Shruti. So he revealed to Brahma. Brahma then spoke to various students, his disciples like Narada. Narada spoke to Vyasa. Vyasa in turn spoke to Pailarishi, Vaisampayan, Jaimini, then Sumantau. So there are a lot of disciples they had. So they did not write. All the Shrutis mean something which they heard and they were repeating, memorizing it. They're going the olden days, they're so powerful that they can memorize the slokas without any mistake. They can repeat it again. That's how this Shruti was handed over. Now, this Vedas, predominantly there was only one Veda, which is called Yajur or Yajush Veda. Then these four Vedas came into picture later. There was only one Veda, which is Yajur. Then Vyasadeva compiled it into four because it's very difficult to understand. One lakh records of mantras. It's very difficult to, so many branches. Somebody wants to know about Ayurveda. He has to go through so many, right? So he divided to Rig, Yajur, Sama, Atharvana. What is this Rig Vedur? Rig is something contains prayers. Prayers means prayers to the gods, various gods or karma kanda you want to do. Then the Yajur is the hymns or mantras which are used for doing perform sacrifice. Fire sacrifice is recommended for the yugas and every human being to achieve their Sanatana Dharma, they all used to do fire sacrifices. Ashwamedha Yagna, if you don't have rain, do Vajpayee Yagna. Ashwamedha Yagna, you want to become a king. All these people, they were performing various Yagna. Putra Kamesti Yagya, if you don't have Putra, I want a nice boy, then you do this. You want to go to Indraloka, there is one Yagya. People were performing this Yagya, that's require a mantra, right? That is all written in Yajur. The third one is Sama. Sama is which is sung, to be sung meterically or poetically. All these prayers, which is in the Rig Yajur, they're written in the song form. so that people can memorize it. There is a particular meter to it. You have to read this sloka like this. Then the Atharvana is other Vedas. Other means extra. Means other than these three is called Atharvana Veda, which talks about how to maintain your body, how to maintain the world, also how to distract. This is knowledge about maintain and distract a personal as well as world. How to maintain a society, how to distract the society, how to commit suicide. Even people who are committing suicide, it is there in the Vedas. And that's why I was mentioning anything you see in the material world, any knowledge, it is there in Vedas. There is nothing outside Vedas. Everything has come. Some of them we don't have. How otherwise a particular person would know how to commit something, right? So there is something is spontaneous because it's already there. As I mentioned, all these knowledges are within us. We just need to clean our mirror to understand this. Now, the Rig Vedas, there are 21 branches. And Yajur had 100 branches. Some had 1,000 branches. And other one had 9 branches originally. This is how they Vyasadeva divided. Then he divided every branch. I'm talking about 21 branch. Imagine Rig Veda had 21 branch. Every branch had Samhita, Brahmana, Aranyaka, and Upanishad. So let me give you briefly what is this Samhita, Brahmana, Aranyaka, Upanishad. Those days, Chaturvarna Maya system, there are 4 kinds of people. Satriya, Brahmana, you have these 4 classes of Sudra, Vaishya. There are 4 kind of people. Only the family people who lived in the cities, the Brahmachari, the young boys, or the Sannyasa, or Vanaprastha, we call. Vanaprastha means one who retired life. After 50, they go to forest and live. So many of the people lived in the forest olden days. Only one portion of it was living in the city, which are family, the family who grastha, you call them. They conduct all this business and all, take food, and they support this rest of the three. Brahmanas doesn't go to work to earn money. The Brahmacharis, they don't go and work. The Vanaprastha also retired, they don't work. So all these three were supported by the Grahastha, the people who are married. So these Vedas were mentioned, divided for those people. When you say Brahmana here, it is not the Brahmana by community we are talking about. This is the type of a book or a branch, especially meant for those people who are living in the city life. Aranyaka means forest. Who are those three people who are living? The Aranyaka's section of it were created. The Samhita is nothing but a collections on different topics and collections of mantras. So this Samhita is like Rig Samhita, Yajur Samhita, Sama Samhita, Atharvana Samhita. You can see there are 4 Samhitas are there. And inside the Samhitas, there were collections of Aitreya mantra. There are few mantras like that. They would have divided, sectioned it. Everything is mantra here. So please understand, Veda is everything is a mantra. It's a particular verse with meter. Then this collection of mantra is called Sukta. And this collection of Sukta is called Samhita. Samhita is nothing but particular topic, collection of mantras. I said Aitarva mantra, Pipalashita mantra. Like that, there are so many mantras they would write it. And this mantra for sacrifice, the Brahmanas and Aranyakas would contain specific sacrifices for how a householder should live, how the person should live. It's not that everybody can go and see what happened. I'll tell you a small story, even though I'm running out of time. This is very important to understand this. So there was one Brahmachari living in the Gurukul, in the forest, of course. His guru told, why don't you go and get some fruits? Then this guy went, he saw one tree. There were 3 fruits were there. He plucked one and brought back to his guru. Then guru asked, did you get fruits? He said, yes. How many fruits you got? He said, 1. He said, how many fruits were in the tree? There were 3, he said. Then he said, you are fool, rascal. You become a blind. Then the disciple got bewildered. He said, why, guru? What I have mistake I have done? You told me to get fruits. I've got it. What is the problem? Then he said, the trees are places where so many living entities live. Birds, even Gandharvas, Kinnaras, there are so many people who live. There are places for so many insects. You just cut the tree. We cut so many trees, right? We are losing, causing abundance of, agony to the so many living entities who are to migrate, right? There are only 3 fruits. There are so many people, so many living entities. You plucked one. You're so selfish. You should have left it and you should have come back and said there is no fruits available. Out of 3, you got 1. This guru cursed him. So there is one food for thought I've written here. when we do construct, right? So okay, let me come to that later. So what happens is the like this in the Vedas talk about how one should live a life in the forest. The king just cannot go into the forest. He can't go with his ratha and all. He might be killing so many plants and animals. He has to get down and walk only with a few ministers. Other places he can walk. So there is how hermitage should be done, how one should not cut the tree, how to construct a hermitage. These all talked about in Aranyakas. Still, are you able to hear me?
Yes.
Brahmanas, yeah, Brahmanas, this is going to end in 10 minutes. I'm going to wind up quickly. The Brahmanas were the place where the city people who live, how to, when you cut the tree from the forest, how do I use it? Because when we construct our house, our city, we construct, kill so many trees, right? This will cause a lot of sinful activities. When we dig our land, we can kill so many insects. So does that mean we should not construct a house? Should y'all go live in the forest? That's a food for thought. I will answer this question next week. So that would talk about how person in city life should behave or work or how to live his earnings ethically. Upanishad is what the philosophical part of it. So the interesting thing is the other Brahmanas, Aranyakas, Samhitas would talk about the Karmakanda session, where how one should get more money, what yajna can they can do, how do they live in the city, how do they support the Brahmanas, how to receive the guest, and how to maintain your life. Everything is there. But this Upanishad is what the philosophical aspect of the Vedas, which would talk about our Sambandha Vidaya Prayojana, who is the Lord. So this why this Upanishad is considered as a Shruti, the important part of it. So there are three books. For Shruti, we refer to Upanishad. For Smriti, it is Bhagavad Gita or Mahabharata. Because the Puranas, based on this Smriti, Upanishad, they would write a commentary or the explanation on how one should live. By Mahabharata, we see how the Dharma is established. So we can refer to the Smriti part of it, Bhagavad Gita, or the 108, there are 18 Puranas, you can refer to either one of that. Then for Nyaya, in order to establish the logic, there is a Brahma Sutra. So the Vedas were condensed into sutras. It's called Brahma Sutra or Vedanta Sutra. There are 500 and plus sutras available. One is Atato Brahma Jignasa. This is one. So this is explained in the Bhagavatam. So these are the three set of books, which is essentially sufficient for us to understand what is Vedas and all. To give you a conclusion, Brahmanas, Aranyakas, you can see that only 18 Samhitas available. Sorry, 7 Aranyakas available. Upanishad 220. There are Samhitas 11. These are currently available. Remaining are lost. The Vedas are already lost, half of the knowledge. Most of the knowledge is not there with us. Only few are there, handful. And also I've given the rishis who are carried down to our next generation. Okay. So we will dwell this in detail about the Aranyakas, Brahmanas, Upanishad, what it contains in the next week. Especially, I'm going to talk about Isha Upanishad. That's one of the prime Upanishad, introduction to Upanishad. The other things, as we today didn't have time, so gradually I would cover that as well next week. But I would stop here for people comments and questions or any other improvements. Then we can take it up next week. Because the meeting is going to end in another 5 minutes. People like to please unmute and ask questions if you have any. And some of the food for thought which I mentioned, I'll be answering it next week. So if you are no questions, I will quickly summarize what we have seen today so that you're clear. So first we established saying that Bhagavad Gita is the Saman Bonam, where the Vedas are explained the tree. So in order to cut the tree, the root, we have to understand from Anatta state to Sanatana state, which is Vedas talks about Sambandha Vidaya Prayojana. And they also have established through the Vedas how the world is created and the Vishnu is our Supreme Father. And the entire knowledge, whatever available in the Vedas, the materially, spiritually, everything is there, which is just be revealed to us, and we have this entire knowledge with us. Then I talked about this Aranyakas, Brahmanas, Upanishad and Samhita from every Veda. This is how it is explained. But you don't see it's a separate book. It's a one chapter, okay, let me go to Brahmanas. It's all intermingled. In the book, if you take of let's say Rig Veda, some portion of it mantras will be there, some portion of it samhitas will be there, some portion of it brahmanas will be there, some portion of it aranyakas will be there. It is very difficult to segregate. But this how the knowledge is been grouped together, and one particular person, Pailya Rishi, who would specialize only in Rig Veda, you would talk about only Rig Veda, what it teaches to that Yajur, then you would talk about Samas, how to poetically recite this sloka. There are people specialized on that areas, and they have written a lot of smritis. That's what I said. Those smritis, what we're going to see, especially those Puranas. So that's a quick summary on the Vedas. I would stop here. Thank you so much. And one kind request, please register. 30 people, it's very difficult to interact. We want to make it batches. Based on the registration, we can talk to you, have a more interactive session. Today, we are not able to have much of interaction. Kindly please subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.
Gopinathji, can this recording be shared?
Unfortunately, this recording did not happen, but I will make a video and I will put it in YouTube. Because there is, I was switching over between laptops and this internet issue. I think there is some technical glitches. If it is there, definitely I can share. But otherwise, definitely I intend to make a YouTube video and it will be available in my channel.
There was power disruption 3-4 times, so I could.
Absolutely, I know there is a lot of technical issues. Apologize for the initial thing, but I hope you appreciate our small endeavor to do that, spread this.
Wonderful. Yes. Namaste. It was a very...
Thank you very
I don't
much
know whether
for
I, hello?
Having this kind yeah. of session.
Am I too fast?
Hello.
Hare Krishna?
Hare Krishna. I'm Geeta Devi here. I mean, it was a well initiated clearing of the mind about, you know, the clutter fear we had about Vedas. And it was a big help to open the receptivity. And thank you very much. It came so well in this stage to help us come out of that fear of, you know, that something which we cannot connect or touch or, you know, receive. So this was wonderful. I mean, I don't know, something beyond it. And your delivery and analytical clarity and simplifying the layers has helped our mind. At least my mind, you know, appreciate the realistic grandeur of the Vedic reality, the knowledge, plus your approach was so helpful. Thank you very much. Thank
it's
you.
It's my pleasure. My pleasure.
This presentation can be shared.
Definitely, I will share. I'm not intent to keep this because I said it's revealed knowledge will be shared across, but I will share this after 2 or 3 sessions because I want you to attend. People, I want to be, you know,
we will attend if you are. It was a good lecture.
Yeah, go ahead, please.
Yeah, it was a good lecture. We will surely attend. But the only thing is, like, I thought once what you have told is fresh in mind when we go through the material, no, it will remain. It does. So in that aspect, I told there's no doubt that we'll not continue to attend or something like that. So in that aspect, if you can share this, it will be really good immediately, so that we can go through it kind of thing.
I agree.
All because
with will,
something
help
something helped
help.
Through it, and it was a very 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 hand-holding effect on the mind. So I think this is a very valuable, if somebody has saved even someone who is participating the audio, at least it has come so expert delivery for, you know, to connect to consciousness. It is just not this particular session I have not attended earlier or whatever, so but this came very technically receivable, and if it is can be saved by anybody, or it is just definitely worth saving the delivery itself like this today. I don't know, that's what
we
I
will
feel.
Be repeating the session Saturday. I will repeat the section in Kannada. You are feel free to come. I have created 2 sessions. The same session will be repeated every Saturday in Kannada, and English will be in every Sunday. In between I'll do that, and definitely I will post this, share with you this, and also I have made a lot of notes which also you will get it in the PPT along with that, and these are something open. We are not doing anything here. And it, YouTube's and WhatsApp, please. That's why it is easy for me to communicate if you subscribe to the WhatsApp channel. That's the mode of communication.